Pro Beauty India show for doing the Pixie cut with me, Bina Punjani. I am going to be handling the handy for the next 2 hours. This is my model Nikita. We've shot before and today she's going to go in for something really brave. And I'm really excited for her look because I think she's got lovely features. And I think the trick with doing the Pixie is you have to know what length. Pixie is traditionally considered to be a very, very, very short haircut, almost like a buzz cut. Well, it is that, but it also means more than just short back and sides. There's a lot of texture, there's a lot of sophistication, there's a lot of finishing, deciding the right length and the shape for the client's hair. So she's been a model for us. This is a previous haircut that has grown out and she's got a few trims in between. What I'm going to be starting with is this section, if you guys can see. It's a horseshoe section, slightly dipping here because this is where we need to make sure your occipital bone is just 2 inches above your occipital bone is your horseshoe. And what I'm going to do today is something really interesting. I've always actually been a scissor girl. I still am. I love my scissors. But today I'm going to be using clippers for her. And the reason being is I think it's one, it's an online, it's a quick thing. When you work with scissors, it does take time and you do have to go section by section. So with clippers, it just becomes easier. But the beauty of working with clippers, when you worked with scissors and understood the shape and the finish, the clippers become much more sophisticated to handle. So what we are going to be doing today is working with the wall clipper. I'm working with the legend for under the horseshoe. I've put on a guard which is number one. I'm going to be doing a clean number one round below the horseshoe for Nikita. And then I'm going to be working with the shape on the top. So let me first start with the hair at the bottom. You finish washing your hair. I'm going to be drying it so that we get a clean, clean finish. The hair on the top is still wet, but we need to dry this hair before we start clipping it. Sure, I'm securing all the parts. What I'm going to do is start with the back and then move on to the side. So with the head slightly tilted forward, not a lot, right? Slightly tilted forward. I'm going to be working with the clipper. And also this is to all the barbers. And I'm standing with them. We are going through a very, very, very tough time. So I'm hoping that everyone, along with my entire community of hairdressers, we stand with you. We hope barbershops start really, really quickly. So I have kept my guard open. It's not closed. This is open and this is going to be closed. Yeah, so I've kept my guard closed right now because I need to take it. I will start with the open, which means that less length is going to come out.
Nikita, are you ready?
So I'm just going to go. What I'm doing is I'm touching the scalp, but I'm leaving out the length on the top a little bit because that's the length I want to work with. Okay? So the movement is touching the scalp and coming out. Touching the scalp and coming out. Okay? So also if you see where I've taken the section really helps because it helps me remove the clipper at the right length. So what is pretty much done in no time, right? So we're just removing the length at this point in time. Just make sure the hair is detangled before you do this. Can you look down for me, please? So this movement, which is touching the scalp, coming out, lets you remain, makes the feminine shape in. You're still having it quite rounded, if you see. It's not become square, not become too flattish. So that's something that we can work with. What this does is when you do this and move out, it tends to keep the length and still remove the weight from inside. This is vertical movement. Now what I'm going to do is horizontal. But now I'm going to close the guard, okay, and stop the clipper. So I'm going to first try with the horizontal with the guard and then remove the guard because it really, I just need to even it out a little bit. So I'm going to remove the guard. Okay. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is show how we can just leave the length but soften the edges to get the shape. Shorter to longer here to keep that angle going, but I'm just gonna make sure that right. So something that would actually take me a little bit longer has gone into finish the bottom quite quickly, and to my, it's quite nice actually. I'm using half and then I'm keeping it open so I get a little bit more leeway when I'm blending. So whenever you want to softly blend, clean up the other side. We also have something called the berry and the detailer, which I'm going to use now. Detailer. Working with something called the detailer. The size is quite interesting. It's small. It's going to be used to create a little bit more definition and actually some lines within the hair. So we'll be doing that before we move to the top.
with the detailer. What I'm going to do is I'm going to be doing three lines here. So I'm going to work with the first line. Okay. This sort of gives some design element, right, to your haircut. So you can really see that. Right, so that's my three lines going through there, and to contrast, I'm going to put in one more on this side. Okay. So this is going to be my secret hidden sort of space in terms of design. So it depends on how she wears her hair. She can expose her design underneath, or she can cover it. So for women, I think it's important to be able to give that option, especially if they're going for the first time, to make them feel a little bit more comfortable with the fact that they can wear it long and they can wear it short at the same time. Especially with Indian hair, what is different about Indian hair? Indian hair is thicker, Indian hair has got a certain texture to it. I'm not saying that all Indian hair is thick, but also hair that generally you decide to take short, you have to be careful with what you're going to be working with. Working with the first line here. Okay. And then we work with the second, which is just slightly inside compared to the first. And I'm going to work with one above, which is top of the eyebrow. Definitely wanted to do these for her, considering the fact that she decided to go very rock and roll, very chic. A lot of hairdressing is also inspired by music. I, Nikita is someone who is into music, if I'm not mistaken. So tell me a little bit about what you do, Nikita.
Well, I'm just a freelance content writer and I model sometimes, but I'm studying journalism right now.
Okay.
And yeah, I do have a knack for music, but it's mostly for movement. Like, I like to listen to it to move.
Right. Okay. Now I'm going to be using my razor. While I've left the angle here for working with the hair. Okay, we're going to work with the razor. Now when you work with the razor, right, you need to make sure your hair is wet. So we're going to be wetting the hair down. Working, yes, that's your hair, Nikita. How does it feel? Tell me how does it feel here?
It feels like I'm free.
You're free. I like that. Yeah, that's what generally happens when people get their hair clipped. Back here, I'm going to detail the front. So what does the razor do? The razor opens up the movement,
cuts into the curl, gives it a nice texture. So it just is something you can work with. You can work with texturizing for the scissor as well, doing this. But razor is just something that breaks the weight much, much heavier than the scissor. And I would not recommend this for very, very fine hair. So you can do the Pixie on fine hair as well, and you can use a clip on fine hair as well. But you just have to know where to start, where to stop, what you're doing. The other exciting thing we're going to be doing for Nikita is basically coloring her hair on Saturday. And it's going to be a very, very different color. So she's going to be a different person. On Saturday, she's going to be a new Nikita. It's actually your birthday also, guys. So a very, very happy birthday to you.
Thank you. I don't know why I've become so camera shy. Lockdown thing.
Okay, so I've just reduced a little weight around here, but we've kept it slightly asymmetrical, which I'll balance it out once I'm finished with the top, because I might want to keep this side a bit longer. I'm going to release the top for you guys so that we can have a look. That's how long the hair was. Okay, so if you see, even if right now this whole undercut can be covered, right? I'm just going to turn her around and you can see all that you can't see now. Okay, all that you can't see. It's all covered. So now that's the area that we are going to be working with. With my 7-inch, scissor, which would be 6.5 to be precise. My 7-inch looks similar, but I'm working with 6.5. What I'm going to do is, if you see, what undercut does is also lets this length contour the face and shape it the way you want it. Because when you have weight here, the head moves like this, and you cannot have the length that will shape your face the way you want it to. Now, because there is no length and weight underneath here and here, I can use this part of the hair to work with shaping. It's like shaping your face like you shape your body with the clothes. For me, hair is like that, so I'm going to be doing that. Also, what we are going to be doing is, there are many options here. Either I can work with a round layer technique, or I can work with an inversion technique. What I want is that her hair on the top should sit slightly below her ear, because I need to texturize it and then it will sit on the top. So when I pick it up, I need to cut about that much length off. Okay, so you're looking at that much length off her hair. And how do I want to cut it? Do I want to build weight on the top, or do I want to build weight underneath? When I have to build weight underneath, then I'm going to be doing an inversion, which is shorter here and longer here. So this will be longer. If I want to remove the weight, then I will be doing the round layer, which all of them will sit at one level. So what I'm going to be doing for Nikita is, because I already like the shape of her head, the way it's sitting right now, so I'm actually going to be doing an inversion for her. It will be an inversion on the top, which is shorter in the front, longer through the back. And on the sides, it's going to be a reverse inversion, which is shorter underneath and still keeping the the front, on the top, it needs to be longer. So I'm going to section the hair off. So like I said, a pixie doesn't have to be a complete barbering look, but you can combine. It's a hybrid. We are living in a world where it's important to understand the meaning of hybrid and use the most efficient way to work something when it's required. Like I said, because for me it was important that I'm doing a live show and I have certain limited time, so I've used a clipper. And I must say the wall clipper, the legend, was very, very easy and comfortable to work with, because I'm not a clipper person. And but I loved it today. I absolutely had fun using it, so I'm going to use it more. And then I've used the detailer to create the lines for more impact. Yeah. So if you see, she already has a fringe. And why, Nikita, have you put a fringe? But that's okay. I'm joking. So you're going to be working with an inversion, right? I'm going to be taking the cube from the fringe, the longest point of the fringe, and I'm going to be slicing her hair. Half open, half close, half open, half close, half open, half close. Okay? I'm going to be seeing if I'm happy with the guide. Yeah, I'm happy with the shape of the guide. I'm just going to go a little bit more flatter. I was quite steep because I wanted to keep the length, but I think this length works for me. I'm going to be combing the hair onto one side as we do. But when I come onto the side, like I said, that will be my longest point, the top. And I'll be working with the guide underneath, which is the guide I'll be creating. So this is my longest point. I'm going to keep my elbow nice and high, and I'm going to be cutting . So I'm creating two guides. One is for the side and one is for the center. So I can mix the two guides and connect the points. Okay, now I'm resting it and seeing if I'm happy with the length and the shape of the guide here. I think I want to take it a little bit more shorter. I'm going to keep it a little longer because there's lots and lots of texturizing to do, which will happen when the hair is dry. This is called wet texturizing. Yeah, that's a good length to work with. I'm going to subdivide that guide. So now I have a guide on the top. Now I have a guide from the back. I'm going to work the two to create and work through the layering in the front. So remember, as you go with your guide in the front, it will keep going shorter in the front. So you have to keep that in mind. So you're taking the guide and you're working the angle to join the top of the guide, okay? Subdividing it, going ahead. Okay, there you go. You can see the guide at the back and in the center. Center. Don't miss the guide because that's going to impact your shape, yeah? So the guide is extremely, extremely important. Working with diagonal forward sections so that there's a bit of length for me to play with when I'm texturizing the hair. So because I've worked with a round shape, you can see that perimeter come through very, very clearly. I'm going to be back cutting this. moving on to the next side. I'm going to take the guide, put it onto the other side, work the other side. Now when you're working the other side, you have to come around in the front because you have your slight cutting here. So again, your guide is your center guide and you're reaching your center guide. Slightly diagonal forward. So if you see, what this is doing is not really layering the top that much. It's keeping the top really, really, really heavy. And Nikita's hair is also quite thick, but it's helping in the sense that because the hair is thick, it lets you play around and texturize it a lot more rather than just. Luckily, you know, even if she's cut the fringe, we are going to manage to work the fringe into the look. Working through the back for her now. Okay, so you've got the length on the side. On both the sides you've got the length. We're going to be working the back with her. The back is going to be a classic vertical graduation in our system, where I'm first taking the radial for this haircut, but otherwise we start with straight away the horseshoe. But in her haircut, because we worked with an undercut, I'm going to be working with a radial and I'm going to be working with a center profile straight out at 90, your fingers slightly turned in and you're going to be point cutting to create your guide. Yeah? Can everyone see that? Sorry. This is good. Yeah, so you have to be able to create that guide. I just created the guide here, which just nicely, really nicely sits around just a little above the area that we've undercut. I'm going to go in with diagonal forwards. Taking the guide alongside with me. Cutting the section to create the movement following the head shape. Continuing going ahead towards the front. finished with this side. And if you see, it's connecting to the front. Okay. Moving on to the other side, do your diagonal front. Make sure your position is proper. Body position is proper. I'm trying to make sure that you guys can see. So you'll have to excuse me if you see any sort of body position that's not correct. But I'm learning to do Instagram live body cutting. You know, it's not that easy. So I'm just going to turn it around. If you can see my guide, 90 degrees, straight out. And it's not even like cutting on stage or cutting for videos, because you know you can really angle yourself, but all the screens look different. It's a new world, so it's, you know, not that easy to adjust yourself. But yeah, I think everyone can see it pretty clearly. So yeah, I'm gonna move here so you guys can see again. A little bit, so keeping that 90 degrees. Nice. I'm doing a pivoting section because I like the round feel through the back, which I will be breaking it up and making quite, flattening it out quite a lot. But it's a nice shape to start with because it gives you that option to flatten it out. What I'm going to do is go back in. We have some more sections remaining. I'm going to go back in. And rework some of the sections to remove the weight. You see, there is a point there. So you've gone shorter, you've gone longer, and you get a point in the center. I'm going to dry the hair and then we're going to work with it, with texturizing it. Audrey liked this shape and she looks really, really cool. I think it's changed her personality completely. And that's what I feel hair does, you know, it just gives you the confidence. And it just makes you look something that you've never imagined yourself to look like. What it's seen in magazines and, you know, but I think that's the thing. When I talk to my clients or my models, I always tell them, you come to me because, you know, I can do the best for you and make it look great for you. So I think that's important. Really nice shape, but I think what I have in mind is a pixie. Okay, so the pixie is, I want to reduce this weight, make it a little bit more squarish, have it a little bit more funky, put in a lot more movement, texture, just more attitude. Okay, so I'm just going to work with that. This foam is also something that comes with the clipper, and it's fantastic to work through thick hair and through clippered hair. So a lot of people like myself were quite are very, very processors and not wanting to get onto clippers, and I think it's important to understand it's not either or, because there will be some haircuts that definitely require clippers. Like when you do fades for men, they are very important. And I think what I realized by working with clippers today is, you know, I think if you've got the background of working with scissors and working with discipline with your scissors, then it's much easier to work with clippers. So the transition won't be that difficult. But again, I would use it only when I know what I want to do with the clipper. I wouldn't use it in every other case. And I think it's important to understand that learning that skill, or learning in general, you have to be a learning person forever if you are into hairdressing and you want to be a successful hairdresser. You have to keep picking up new skills. So right from the time when I started to the time now, I have always wanted to learn a new skill within my field. Also, something like wig making is something that really interests me, but I don't do it right now because there's too much on my plate, but someday I'll do that as well. That's on my bucket list for hairdressing. So I'm working through the sections in the same way as I've cut them after I'm seeing how it's falling, and I'm also blending the disconnected sections. Very important, whenever you take disconnected sections, they will get blended only if you have had an idea in mind, otherwise they will stay disconnected. And if you forcibly try to connect them, the finish is not going to be that great. A little bit wet here. If you remember, I've not yet done any kind of styling, no dry. I just use my fingers. Scooping, working inside every section to break it up, okay, and to shape it up. Break it up and shape it up, yeah. So if you see, this is her, just look down for me, Nikita. This is her crown area. This for me is extremely important whenever you're doing any directional haircuts or when you finish the haircut. This will make, or this is the power of the hairdresser. If the hairdresser knows how to use the crown area really well, you will be able to control the movement of your haircut in an excellent way. But yeah, it requires a lot of discipline when you're cutting the hair, when you're cutting the sections, how you respect the sections when you pick them up, how you respect the hair. If you respect the hair will listen to you. If you don't respect the hair will not listen to you, and it's going to be not great. You will not enjoy it. I'm also doing something called channeling, which is breaking up the weight. Yeah, so you can see that little peep through, which you'll see more once we get closer. We can do is now just going with this is a comb technique and filter while lifting the hair for it to lift. You're removing your scissor out, right? You're going horizontal, here. Deep parallel point cutting. So if you see, I've reduced the weight, but I've kept the shape in. Okay, I'm not taking the shape away by layering it too much at the top. Breaking the wave that's curving around by going in the opposite direction and then combing it out so it sits straight, yeah? Sharpness. Everything is about sharpness. This is the scissor. I'm just tilting it. Yeah, I'm just going to be tilting it a little bit. Going like this. What this is doing is just removing the weight. Now I want to work with taking the slight movement away where I'm just going to be going in the opposite direction but not removing the length. So all these techniques, right? All these techniques need a lot of control. So the minute you control, again reminder that there is no blow drying on this. And she started with super thick hair, super heavy hair with a lot of movement. And this is the texture we've been able to achieve with cutting the hair with the right technique and the right movement. I'm gonna take that off to you. shape through the back, through the sides, a little bit more, which I'm going to work square while slicing it on the top. Why am I taking square sections? Is removing a little bit more weight at the highest point of the head so that we get the texture and movement going through. Opens up a face, yeah, you can see this is opening up a face. It's not riding with a helmet on a face, yeah, so we have to open that up for, but still keep it nice and feminine and textured, look with a lot of attitude. This is called back cutting, opening the scissor, pushing. Taking that section, spreading it out, back cutting it, working with the movement. Again, no blow dry. I'm just going to be saying that 10 times because I feel that a lot of the times the hairdressers try and rely on blow drying to make their hair look good. Okay, so the idea is to not use a blow dry because a client is not going to be using the blow dry every day at home. So it's important to do wash and go haircuts. How can you do wash and go haircuts when you cut them technically correctly? This is called back cutting. creating internal layers by leaving the length in, removing the weight, creating internal layers and movement, taking away unwanted. So if you remember, she had a fringe, yeah? Now her fringe is blended in. I'm gonna now go on the back side, but before that I'm gonna be ironing her hair. I'm again using a wall iron machine. Okay, they have a temperature control. It's quite a thick flat blade, so I can work through very, very quickly with her hair. I'm gonna have one of my team members assist me so that we can work quickly with it. So I'm just gonna be detailing certain parts of her hair. And that too really quickly. I'm not spending tons of time on it. I just want to be able to run wax through the hair. So it tends to help in that. Working very selected sections really, if you see, I'm just waiting to create the texture and movement of styling, putting the wax in, but it's by no way that she needs to do this every day. She can really wear the hair as is. seeing what I've done.
Okay.
So, going in with my third thing, which is a texturizing scissor. I'm going to pick up certain areas and just half and half, okay? Need to break it up. So I kept this side longer. I'm gonna go in and really, really texturize this one because I want it like very minimally longer, not that much. It's just to create that little asymmetry from the other side. But I still want it really, really sharp. I want the undercut to be exposed in some way. Nikita is just waking up, so she'll give us her excitement and expressions in some time. Once we are done with the haircut and style it for her. So if you see guys, what is happening now is all just detailing. Detailing the shape more, detailing the shape further. And unless everything is about detailing, yeah, unless you have your detailing in place, you're not going to be able to work through the haircut. So I'm again just twisting it, cutting it with the texturizing scissor this time, of course. Just tilt your head. And what I'm doing is back cutting this. Okay, so when you back cut, you get a lot of softer edges. To get the disconnection between your everything at the right place and for the right reasons. So if I had done the lines slightly above, they would have been hidden by the length. But now they are exposed and it's nice. It's just the right point. Again going in. Breaking it up. Just the ends. Detailing the ends, okay? Detailing the ends. To the side. Thank you. thick here, so we're gonna go in, twist it, and right up. This is also where you get volume, movement, a lot of shape for the haircut comes from this area. So it's very important to make sure it's just rightly done, the amount of texturizing. That's the other thing you could ask your clients to do, especially when you're texturizing, is keep the eyes closed because you want to be able to work through your technique without troubling the client. So I'm going to ask you either to keep your eyes closed for the next 5 minutes to let finish the haircut. Dust off the brush and give it to the brush. I'm just working now with the perimeter area. finally toward the end. So what we're going to be doing with this haircut, I'll just tell you what is going to happen with this look for Saturday. Is we're going to be coloring with my hair, which means that this is going to look completely different. It's going to look another new person on Saturday. It will just add, I always feel color gives a lot more attitude, a lot more fun to looks like this especially. I'm also going to talk about products, products that she should be using, products that clients should be using, products that hairdressers should be using when it comes to doing this. So yes, let me just check the weight all around. It's all good. You'll be styling it. She can wear it in many ways. It's going to be fantastic. Let's see. Exposing the lines again. This is where the lines come through. Work through your undercuts exposed here as well. Like I said, I've left this side a bit longer because of the asymmetry. I was going to be making my hair work to this side. Taking some time to just, work the different shapes into her hair, because I'm really enjoying how the hair is looking. I mean, for me, that is important too. As a hairdresser, if I've worked with something, I need to really be happy with it. There's some amount of strays that I'm going to take off. Mm-hmm. once I've finished styling the hair, if I want the hair to be, especially the lines to be exposed, then I'm gonna have to cut this part a little bit shorter so that it works into the texture. Works into the fringe, becomes a part of the fringe. Clearly see now the shape coming through. Yeah, that's my pixie for today. Quick recap, what we've done is we've worked with the clipper, I've worked with the ball clipper, it's the legend series, with the guards of 1.5 and 1/2 with close and open at the same time. Then I've also worked with something called the detailer. I've worked these lines with the detailer and the lines in the side with the detailer. Okay, so that sort of gives me a little bit of movement for her hair. Sorry guys, I'm just adjusting my camera. Yeah, there. Yeah, look there. That was nice. Okay, so that, if you see that the detailer is something that I've worked with. For the horseshoe, I have worked with inversion technique, but also round layers, because round layers is something that will give it shape and with it, it will give the movement required for the hair. Lot of texturizing. If you saw, almost the same amount of time that I spent cutting her hair, I spent texturizing it. And now here we have it. So, Nikita, that's your new birthday gift for you.
Thank you. I don't need to set it or not, right?
Sorry?
I don't need to set it or not.
Not at all. So you saw I hardly used anything except for wax. And if you work with the wax, you should be able to handle this pretty easily. So if you just step this side, please. So guys, I'm going to be logging off now. It was great. Thank you all for joining me. Look forward to seeing you on Saturday for the same haircut, the pixie cut with color. I will be explaining the products that I'm going to be using, the level which I'm going to be lifting it to, how will I finish it off. So do log in. If you have any questions, you can write in to Pro Beauty India, you can write to Bina Punjani, and we will be happy to take your questions in for Saturday. Till then, stay safe, lots of love, and stand together with the entire hairdressing community. See you soon. Thank you.